perfect.
There you go. Won't be ahead after the last lunch.
Leaked footage has emerged showcasing Mike Tyson's formidable training regime, igniting anticipation for his upcoming bout against Jake Paul. At 57, Tyson's prowess on the pads remains undiminished, highlighting Tyson's undiminished power and speed despite his age.
Nice. Extremely vicious workout, right?
Following the fight's announcement, Tyson boldly declared his intent to terminate Paul's boxing journey. The contrast between the two is stark, as Tyson has been seen relying on a cane for support on several occasions. Moreover, Tyson's struggles with sciatica in 2022 further highlight the toll that time has taken on his once formidable physique. In an interview with Greta Van Susteren, Tyson said, "I have sciatica every now and then, it flares up. When it flares up, I can't even talk." At this, when several figures are worried about Tyson's health, Manny Pacquiao still has faith in Mike's abilities. He recently shared his views on the showdown between Jake Paul and Mike Tyson. When questioned about Paul's chances against the 57-year-old Tyson, Manny expressed doubt, stating, "I don't think so," before walking away, leaving his statement to resonate. However, the renowned figure of UFC Conor McGregor has hinted at his lack of enthusiasm towards participating in this particular match. McGregor likely saw little reason to bring the retired legend back into the ring, especially against a considerably younger opponent like the problem child. McGregor expressed, "It's a bit strange. The interest is low. I don't know. I don't really understand it. I always root for Mike." With the Paul versus Tyson bout looming, many fans, even the outspoken, the notorious himself, may find themselves leaning towards one side. McGregor hinted at his support for the revamped Tyson, dubbing him Tyson 2.0.
"Help me.
Your thoughts on this Mike Tyson and Jake Paul fight?"
"Oh, geez, I thought it's a bit strange. You know, the interest is a low one. I don't know. I don't understand it.
Any difference between this one and..."
"I wish well for Mike."
"We're gonna go. Awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate it."
However, whether McGregor's predictions align with reality remains to be seen. Meanwhile, in light of recent sightings of Mike Tyson relying on a cane, voices such as Oscar De La Hoya's are advising Jake Paul against underestimating the ex-heavyweight champion. These cautionary messages are echoing from various corners, all aimed squarely at the YouTuber. De La Hoya said, "Jake Paul, you say you want to be a world champion. You say you want to take this sport seriously. Then take it seriously. What is this? This is not a popularity contest." Moreover, Oscar De La Hoya remains resolute convinced that this will mark Jake Paul's most formidable trial yet. Despite harboring reservations about the bout itself, Oscar asserts that Mike Tyson's presence is likely to pose considerable obstacles for Jake Paul. De La Hoya added, "I'm actually praising Jake Paul for taking this sport seriously, because I really feel that if he fights the right fights and takes the right path to that world title, he can actually get there. I'm not sure because it's up to him if he can win it, but he can get there." Indeed, his primary concern lies in the preservation of Mike Tyson's legacy as he grapples with the notion of Tyson facing a boxer of lesser caliber. De La Hoya emphatically expressed his reluctance towards the matchup, albeit acknowledging the rationale behind Tyson and his opponent seizing the opportunity. Despite his reservations, De La Hoya concedes that the fight is poised to attract considerable attention and generate substantial revenue.
"Through Mike Tyson, he's gonna make a shitload of money. He's gonna gain more popularity on Mike Tyson's expense. Do I like it? No, because I love Mike Tyson."
Moreover, De La Hoya added that it would not be dangerous for Tyson because Tyson had been in the ring with monsters. He mentioned that Tyson has a chin and expressed his confidence that Tyson could still go 6, 7, or 8 rounds. However, De La Hoya also expressed his concern about Tyson's legacy. He added, "It will not be dangerous for Tyson because Tyson has been in the ring with monsters. He has a chin. I'm sure he can still go 6 rounds, 7 rounds, 8 rounds. But I'm just concerned about Tyson's legacy." With several months remaining until we can eagerly watch Mike Tyson and Jake Paul go head-to-head on our Netflix screens, the problem child is already stirring the pot, challenging Iron Mike on Instagram. Despite Tyson's mild response, suggesting he could put him to sleep, Paul has intensified the exchange, doubling down with a follow-up post on Instagram stories. "While I appreciate the younger fighter's confidence and bravado, it seems he may underestimate the magnitude of his opponent. True, Mike Tyson may be 57 years old, but his legacy as one of the most formidable figures in the fighting world is undeniable. With a record of only 6 losses out of 58 professional matches and a staggering 44 wins by knockout, Tyson's prowess is legendary. While some may recall his eccentric cameo in The Hangover, true sports aficionados remember him as Iron Mike, a force to be reckoned with inside the ring, and his leaked training footage says a lot about his skills. Paul may be pinning his hopes on the fact that Tyson's prime days are long gone, and he hasn't stepped into the ring since 2020. Nevertheless, in the realm of professional fighting, much depends on training and skill. Despite not being in peak condition, Tyson retains his wealth of experience. It's remarkable that considering his age nearing 60, he maintains impressive physical fitness. One of the pivotal aspects setting Tyson apart lies in his approach to the game. While his opponent might be downplaying his abilities through trolling, Tyson doesn't seem to be falling into the same trap. His blunt critique of his son's decision to face Paul and his insights into why traditional boxers resent the Paul brothers indicate a deeper understanding cultivated over time. Now coming back to Tyson's leaked training footage, here is how he recently smashed his own trainer.
Yeah, today was the day, you know? Play with fire, sometimes happen.
On the other hand, Jake Paul remains undeterred despite the resurfacing of training footage featuring Mike Tyson. He said, "A member of my team sent me this video that Mike's coach put up 2 weeks ago and asked me if I'm sure that I want to do this. Yes, yes I do, heavyweight." Paul also added, "He's the greatest heavyweight of all time and the most vicious knockout artist ever. But I'm younger, I'm faster, and I'm going to be working my ass off to get stronger." Despite the footage surfacing from 4 years prior, Paul has remained silent on its origins, even as the context has since emerged beneath the post on X. He is also unsurprisingly bullish about his chances against the fighter, 3 decades his senior. A separate post from Paul says, "My sights are set on becoming a world champion, and now I have a chance to prove myself against the greatest heavyweight champion of the world, the baddest man on the planet, and the most dangerous boxer of all time. Time to put Iron Mike to sleep." Meanwhile, in a comedic skit, Jake endeavored to portray a facade of fury, alleging that Mike had mistaken him for his brother Logan Paul during their initial encounter. Jake tweeted, "I idolized Mike Tyson until the first time I met him 4 years ago. He called me Logan. Going to make sure he knows who I am, real close and personal." But just as he boasted about knocking Mike out, Jake swiftly backtracked on his audacious claim.
"You heard it right, motherf***er. I'm fighting Mike Tyson."
"Oh shit.
I'm just so glad to have the honor to step in the ring with one of the most brutal and vicious and most ruthless champions there's ever been."
Everyone is well aware of the evident peril looming over the YouTuber, a fact even he acknowledges, evident in the skit he produced. While Jake Paul may be the primary purveyor of bravado, Tyson's mere glance is enough to induce a desire for sturdier undergarments. Meanwhile, fresh from overseeing UFC 299, Dana White found himself in the spotlight. Talking about the Tyson versus Paul fight, he said, "He gets mad when I do this. I asked him not to fight, but Mike's almost 60 now, man. I don't know." The 54-year-old event organizer expressed a modicum of curiosity about witnessing Mike Tyson's capabilities at his current age. Nevertheless, he harbors reservations regarding matchups like Jake Paul versus the legendary Iron Mike, citing the substantial contrast between the two fighters and expressing disapproval of such unequal contests. Dana White added, "I love Mike Tyson personally as a friend, and he's one of my favorite athletes of all time. Let's see what he can do. Go in there, put together a training camp, and come in. I don't like seeing guys at his age fighting it." Additionally, he highlighted the primary rationale behind his lack of enthusiasm for Tyson's forthcoming bout with Jake Paul. Moreover, Dana White voices concern, questioning the fairness of pitting Paul against the seasoned Iron Mike, given their substantial age gap of over 3 decades. He further stated, there is a 31-year age difference during that fight. Additionally, Dana White has made it clear that neither he nor the UFC is inclined towards arranging such bouts. This stance has been unwavering over the years, with the 54-year-old asserting that his sentiments regarding fighters with significant age disparities are well known. You guys know what I think about that stuff, White added.
During that fight, just, you know. You guys know what I think of that stuff.
Now, at 57, Tyson aims to close the loop by confronting the younger challenger in what he envisions as a defining moment. However, amidst the anticipation, concerns are raised by analyst Stephen A. Smith, who worries about Tyson's well-being stepping back into the ring. During the broadcast of the Stephen A. Smith Show, the 56-year-old commentator emphasized Tyson's recent reliance on a cane for walking. Smith remains unconvinced by the hype as he said, "I confess to you that I can't buy the hype at this particular moment in time." Consequently, while acknowledging the buzz surrounding the Paul versus Mike matchup, Smith expressed genuine concern about the potential for Tyson to sustain significant injury. Smith said, "Daniel Cormier told me the last time he saw Mike Tyson was when Mike Tyson last year walked into a UFC fight, walking with a cane. It's hard for me to believe that somebody walking into an arena with a cane is going to be in the kind of shape necessary to go up against somebody 30 years younger." In this particular scenario, it's pertinent to note that in addition to being spotted using a cane on multiple occasions, Tyson also grappled with sciatica, as mentioned before. This ailment compelled Tyson to depart Miami International Airport in a wheelchair back in 2022.
Recently, he's been posting videos of his workouts on social media. So here's the question, are you buying the hype? I wish I could.
However, Stephen A. Smith lauded Jake Paul for taking the fight against Mike Tyson. "It's Mike Tyson. That's fine. It's a money fight, I get you," said Smith. However, he hoped the problem child would take his career as a boxer seriously at some point in time. He added, "If you keep telling us that you're taking boxing seriously, you're gonna have to fight somebody closer to your age. Somebody who is a contender at the very least in the sport. You don't have to fight Canelo Alvarez or David Benavidez, but you are going to have to fight a bona fide legitimate fighter. Now let's go back in time." So, 2 years back, during an appearance on a podcast, Mike Tyson shared his forecast on the potential outcome of a bout with Jake Paul. Tyson brushed off the boxing abilities of Paul when asked if he could beat the influencer on the Full Send podcast. Tyson said, "So f***ing easy, but I would never. It's my own family. He's got balls. I'm talking about real balls like f***ing motherfucker. His punches you can see coming a mile away. You can see that coming a mile away. I'm 55. I can see that coming a mile away." Tyson also mentioned that he would only need 4 weeks of training to prepare for the fight, asserting that with daily boxing training for 30 days, he could beat both Jake and Logan Paul without needing to focus on dieting, as the training would suffice. He said, "I would beat these fuckers, Jake and Logan Paul. I'd go straight at them. There would be no boxing. The only thing I have to do is be in shape. 30 days of boxing training every day and I can fight anyone. If I'm boxing every day, I wouldn't even have to worry about diet." On the flip side, after the fight announcement, Jake Paul emphasized the importance of the event, suggesting that it would be a significant match regardless of the viewers' allegiances or their familiarity with boxing. Paul said, "Whether you're Team Paul or Team Tyson, or whether you're a lifelong boxing fan or watching your first fight, you're not going to want to miss this event." Finally, Tyson expressed his anticipation for the potential fight with Jake Paul, noting Paul's improvement as a boxer and the excitement of testing a young fighter's will and ambition against his own experience and skill. Tyson described the potential matchup as a full circle moment that would be thrilling to witness. Tyson said, "I'm very much looking forward to stepping into the ring with Jake Paul. He's grown significantly as a boxer over the years. It will be a lot of fun to see what the will and ambition of a kid can do with the experience and aptitude of a goat. It's a full circle moment that will be beyond thrilling to watch." However, not everyone is sold on the matchup, with columnist Skip Bayless finding it difficult to wrap his head around the idea of Paul facing off against Tyson. In the most recent installment of Undisputed, Bayless openly mocked the upcoming fight set for July 20th.
"You don't think people give him a break being almost 60 years of age?
Give who a break?
Tyson. Like, if he did lose, wouldn't they say, well, he's almost 60 years old?
Taking a different stance, he challenged the prevailing belief that Tyson would easily triumph over Paul, asserting his disagreement with the popular opinion as the problem child made his dissent public. "Well, I'll watch it. It's like a barroom argument that came to life," said Bayless. Despite Nikisa Badarin, Jake Paul's manager, anticipating the Paul versus Tyson bout to shatter viewership records in contemporary boxing, dissenting voices echo against the impending spectacle. Skip Bayless scoffed scoffs at the notion of the matchup, suggesting it was conceived whimsically over drinks in a dimly lit barroom by a handful of individuals. Skip said, "Guys might be having some drinks and say, what if Jake Paul fought Mike Tyson like right now? What would happen? That's just something you throw around and argue about it. Mike Tyson would kill him." But all of a sudden, it's almost like that pipe dream of a fight came to life, and somebody said, "Let's see what happens." However, as soon as these remarks came to Paul's notice, the problem child took to Instagram stories and wrote, "No, I don't agree, Skip." According to Paul, the notion of the brawl didn't originate in a bar, and he doubts Tyson's ability to defeat the problem child. Paul revealed that the genesis of the idea dates back 4 years. Similarly, Matchroom Boxing CEO Eddie Hearn found himself fielding questions about the much-discussed Paul-Tyson showdown. Answering the questions, he said, "You're asking the wrong guy. I'm a hardcore boxing fan. He's one of my heroes. I find it very sad." Hearn noted that as a hardcore boxing fan and someone who idolized Tyson, he found the event rather disappointing. Hearn acknowledged that while the match would be a major event attracting viewers and serving as entertainment, from the perspective of someone who deeply admires Tyson and values traditional boxing, it was not a pleasing development.
"Yeah, you're asking the wrong guy. I'm a hardcore boxing fan. He's one of my heroes. I find it very sad. But it's a big event. I understand people are going to watch it. And it's entertainment, I guess, but for someone that idolized the guy growing up."
He implied that for genuine boxing enthusiasts, seeing such a spectacle was disheartening. In a separate quote, Hearn continued to pile on. "It's a big event. I understand people are going to watch it. It's entertainment, I guess. But for someone who idolized the guy growing up, yeah, not the best day. For real lovers of boxing, it's sad to see." Opinions on the impending bout differed widely. But Le'Veon Bell, the ex-Pittsburgh Steelers sensation now in the boxing ring, is confident that the match will culminate in a decisive knockout. Bell anticipates that Iron Mike will exhibit formidable prowess in the initial stages, but foresees him eventually succumbing to exhaustion and being defeated. Bell's central focus appears to orbit predominantly around the generational disparity existing between Tyson and Paul. He tweeted, "He's going to be able to do that for about 30 seconds in round one, then he will be tired and get knocked out. But I'm not surprised that this is the perspective from people who don't fully understand boxing. While nostalgia may sway many towards Tyson due to his legendary history, Olympic medalist Tony Jeffries implores boxing enthusiasts to refrain from allowing sentiment to cloud their judgment when assessing the impending clash." Jeffries said, "With the fights that Mike Tyson's had in his career against the best heavyweights out there, taking some big solid punches to the chin, being knocked out multiple times, and with the lifestyle he's been living, what do you think his punch resistance will be like now?" Observing the prevailing trend among fans favoring Mike Tyson for victory in a bout against Jake Paul, Jeffries felt compelled to interject his perspective. He sought to elucidate why Tyson might face challenges against Paul, emphasizing that Tyson no longer embodies the formidable Iron Mike persona of yesteryears.
"Mike Tyson versus Jake Paul? I've got so many thoughts on this. How it is absolutely disgusting and it should not be allowed. On the other side, I'm like, wow. A round of applause for these guys."
Jeffries highlighted Tyson's departure from an athlete's lifestyle, contrasting it with Paul's dedicated adherence to the professional athlete's regimen, evident in his lengthy training camp preparations. Then he compared him with his younger opponent. He said, "Jake, on the other hand, has been living like an elite athlete. He's got the money to be able to hire the best teams, the best nutritionist, the best chefs, the best training team, the best strength coaches, everything he's got there to be." Jeffries went on to assign fault to the ex-boxing champion's entourage, insinuating that they could have instilled the notion in his mind. So, that's all from today's video. If you enjoyed it, remember to leave a like, subscribe, and ring that bell icon so you never miss our upcoming videos.